Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for joining me today. I'm going to show you guys how to set up ExpressVPN on a DumaOS router, preferably the XR500 or the XR1000. These are both Netgear's top of the line pro gaming routers. They're supposed to lower your ping. You have things like geo-filtering and quality of service. They also have a Hybrid-VPN option, which confuses a lot of people because they have only two VPNs that are supported out of the box, which is pure VPN and HMA, which is hide my. But with that being said, I'm going to show you how to set up manually the ExpressVPN on the XR500 router. Let's get to it. All right, so the first thing you're going to do is go to expressvpn.com. And then once you're logged in, go ahead and select more under setup your devices. And a new tab will launch. Once that new tab launches, what you're going to look for is you're going to look for manual configuration. Select that. And on the right side, you should have this little toggle pop up. You're going to want to select Open VPN. And what's very important here is you're going to copy your username and password. Just have them set up for now. And then also determine which server you're going to want to connect to, whether you're in the Americas, Europe, wherever. All right, the next thing you're going to want to do is go ahead and open up your Duma OS login at the router. So if you have an XR500 or XR1000, it's going to be routerlogin.com. Then you just log in with your admin credentials. Once you're there, you're going to head down here to Hybrid VPN. And once Hybrid VPN opens, go ahead and click VPN Setup. Now, you can use one of your providers if you have those. You just plug in your credentials and it's pretty easy that way. But if you're using something like ExpressVPN, you're gonna click Advanced. Now the username and password, you're gonna take these from what you saw earlier on the ExpressVPN page. From there, you can go and plug in your username, your password, just use a copy and paste. And the configuration file is the part that confuses people. And it's very picky, so you have to make sure there is no extra spaces or any extra characters that are not supposed to be there. So we're gonna head back to the ExpressVPN. So you're gonna copy this one as the username and this one as the password. Now, once you've determined your region, you're going to select this, like here I'll select New York, and it's going to try to download a file. Go ahead and save that anywhere you can access it. Now, when you open the file, it's going to look something like this. And if it doesn't give you an option to open, it says open with, just open it with Notepad. Very easy to do. What we're going to do here is we're basically going to do Control All and then Control C. So now we're back in the Duma OS and we're under the configuration file, we're just gonna paste it. So you can either right click, click paste, or Control V to paste it. And the issue I had is the screen doesn't, you know, show the accept button. So you have to actually minimize the screen a little bit. So hold Control and scroll your mouse, or you can use the toggles and then click connect. And this you need to pay close attention to. So it says that we're connected, but we are not connected because it still shows my location and it still says my IP. Whenever I, you know, go hop on Google, say, what is my IP or where am I located? It'll show me exactly where I am, which is not correct. So what we're gonna have to do is actually go back into the VPN setup. And within the configuration file, I can already tell right here, this little space right here, this little enter bar, we actually gotta delete that. And then we click connect again. And then that will fix the issue. A lot of people, they get run their head around. I mean, I spent an hour with this trying to figure out what was wrong, and it just ended up being one little thing like that that fixed it. And the last thing we need to do is go ahead and add the devices. So click add device. And here I'm just gonna select a Samsung phone, click done. And this mode right here, this little mode icon, don't get too confused, but if you select it, you can apply the VPN on these services. That only applies if you actually add a service, but we're not doing that. We want to just apply the VPN as a blanket to whatever devices we want. So you just click add device and you're done, and just leave everything as is. Hope you guys found this video useful. If you're interested in the XR500 or 1000, there's a link down below. Please hit that like button and subscribe. It does help the channel out. And as always, if you have any questions, go ahead and leave them down in the comment section and I'll do my best to reply. Till next time.